Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to bring you the Vision video. Today, I want to go over the introduction of textiles and the legacy caches into the Vision 2. If you guys are not familiar, these things were talked about yesterday on the study game. And if you guys haven't seen the full live stream, I would highly recommend you check out my video from yesterday. It was a synopsis video of the study game. It was pretty informative, I will say. They talked about episode 3, the new specialization, the new exotic weapon, some of the kind of changes they're doing to shotguns and stuff like that. So pretty informative, although it wasn't everything that people were expecting. Hopefully in the future we get that kind of information, but for the first study game of 2020, it wasn't too bad. Once again, it was kind of mainly focused on episode 3. But anyway, today I want to do a dedicated video to the introduction of textiles and the legacy caches that were talked about. We also received a kind of more detailed article about this yesterday, so again, wanted to make a video. If you guys are not familiar with this kind of system coming, hopefully this video explains that and keeps you in the loop. Alright, so the first thing I do want to talk about is the introduction of textiles, and what they say is, there has been some feedback around receiving duplicates in standard apparel caches, and we want to improve the system to address some of your frustration. Specifically, we understand that receiving XP for duplicates in standard caches does not feel rewarding, and we are introducing a new type of currency in place of XP in the near future, introducing textiles. With every duplicate received in the standard apparel caches, you will automatically receive a portion of textiles instead of XP. Once you collect enough textiles, you will be able to use this currency to eventually make direct purchases of majority of the items on the in-game store. We hope this upcoming change will allow you a more predictable path to obtaining some existing apparel and target specific items. As always, you still have the option to directly purchase cosmetics with pre-run credits through the in-game store. So yeah, this is the new textiles kind of system coming into the Division 2 for apparel caches in the near future. To be honest, I'll be 100% honest right now, it does not really affect me too much because I'm one of those people that collects my apparel caches like all the time. I don't really open them. I think at this time that I'm recording the video, I have like 60 of them just sitting here, and I don't know, I've been rocking with the same fit for many, many months, and I know some people that are, you know, just grinding every single apparel event and opening all the caches, trying to collect everything that is in the game, but personally for me, I've been just rocking with, again, the same fit, the same clothes and stuff, so I do understand this change though. I think it's a great change for people that are collecting items and, you know, opening a lot of caches. If your RNG sucks, if your luck sucks, and you keep getting duplicates instead of receiving XP for that, now you will get these textile points that you can collect and purchase whatever you want in the store in the future. So if you are looking for a specific camo from a specific event or something and you can't get it, you just keep getting the same things over and over again, it'll be a lot easier to kind of obtain it and just purchase it with these points. So again, pretty cool idea. Let me know how you feel about this, if you think this is a great introduction, if you think this is something that wasn't really needed, or I don't know, just let me know your opinions about this in the comment section below. The next thing we do have is the legacy cache, and what they say about this is, if you are looking for more apparel options using premium credits, we are providing a new type of cache containing a selection of older items, introducing the legacy cache available now in game. Priced at 100 premium credits, this is a new opportunity if you aren't necessarily targeting something specific, but would like more apparel previously available. If you are in fact after a specific item, be sure to check out the in-game store for direct purchases. Then they also say, going forward, this cache will periodically be available for a limited time with apparel event Silent Night over. The first legacy cache is live now for a limited time and can be accessed within the apparel cache menu. To celebrate, we're giving everyone who logs into the Division 2 between January 7th and the 14th, 3 legacy cache keys. Don't forget, this cache can also be gifted to friends or clanmates who are missing apparel. Legacy caches guarantee no duplicates, and its contents can be previewed in-game within the cache menu. So yeah, this is the new legacy cache available now in the Division 2. To be honest, I don't really know how I feel about this. Personally, I kind of grew a hatred to spending money for in-game content like caches or supply drops. I don't know why. It could be from previous Call of Duties like supply drops in Advanced Warfare. If you guys used to play that game, you were kind of forced to buy supply drops in that game because the weapon variants and stuff like that. Obviously, it's not the same thing. These are just cosmetics, so it's a different kind of story. But personally, I don't think I will be kind of partaking in this, because again, I would just rather play the game, farm, and get my keys like that, open my crates like that. But it's personal preference. If you want to spend money, real money, on premium credits, and you want to open these caches to possibly get something you've been looking for from previous events, this is obviously for you. If not, you could just kind of disregard this and keep going on with your day. So that's that. I guess it's a pretty cool addition for people, that are collecting stuff, but again, not really something that was necessary, in my opinion, for the apparel caches in the Division 2. But let me know your opinions in the comment section below, how you feel about this. If you disagree with these caches kind of coming out, if you agree with them, kind of let me know what you think about them in the comments. But anyway, that'll be it for the video. This is the new textiles system and the new caches in the Division 2 available. Once again, if you didn't see my kind of synopsis video of the city game yesterday, highly recommend you check it out. I will have a link in the description. But yeah, that's pretty much everything for today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. But once again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.